Hello, my name is Jingo Nelly, and for today we are going to be looking at business statistics, and we are going to join Madame Ruthie's class. She shared with me a PDF, but some of the information ain't there, so you need to be with a notebook so that you can jot down important information. So with business statistics, we are going to be looking at understanding the meaning of statistics and the branches of statistics, then describing the uses and the roles of statistics in business management, then the basic concepts and for example the population sample parameter and statistic, then describe data and various types, then data collection and methods and presentation methods. Then after us knowing that, what exactly is statistics? Now with statistics, the cardinal compass for statistics is decision making, and with the decision making, we are going to be looking at the application stroke the role, which is going to be specific, and later we shall be looking at the function or the importance, which will be in general. So after you knowing that, there are different roles of statistics in different sectors, that is the banking, education, business, then the transport, then manufacturing, so and also the human resource, economics, the finance. So Madame Ruth is going to be taking us through some of these sectors, and that's when you are going to join her in a live class. So let's join Madame Ruth.
Make If you go to Gatu Shoppers, for example, someone will tell you, go in this row, and this court is where you find my kitchen. Those are matrices. Those are straight lines, for example. Those are quantitative or statistical techniques which you can use to avoid guesswork. And transportation. You say, how much should I charge clients? How much do I put so that I don't use guesswork? Because if I will transfer a taxi and I transport people from town to Kono, how much fuel do I get and use? Because you book 10,000, clients reach Nakawa, fuel is over. So you need, even in the small houses you have, even your comfort zone at home, you need data. You analyze it and use it to make your decisions in order to avoid guesswork. Human resource department. If that is your business entity, you need data on the employees, you need data on the salary scale, you need data on how much you discuss to SSL, you need data to know how much that. So that is the data you need. Remember we said data is a collection of ideas to know the state of affairs, which will guide you to reduce guesswork and make valid decisions. In human resource, you must also need data on the qualifications. If I want to promote you certified, maybe professorship, then she has the required papers. As a human resource manager, you must know such kind of data for you to make a valid decision. Either promote this person or not. You have a company, human resource. Which kind of data will you collect on your employees to know whom to promote, to know whom to demote, to know whom to chase? You need data. You won't use this work and say, Wilson looks bad. Let me just chase him. No. You won't use this work to say, no. No, there must be a kind of data, how constitution, how performance. You look at all that data and make the right decision whether to promote her or not. Economics. If you got all to do, so like Minister of Finance and Economic Governance, we are all Ramadan. They have a lot of data. They have data science. An example. Even population secretaries, that's right. But they are population models. They are also economic models. Like, we have the Keynesian model of consumption. You can predict and know if the possible increases, how much should I spend? That is all economics. In economics, mostly, we develop models. A model is just an equation which we get from two variables. We shall see what the variable is. When you form that equation or a model, you use that model for prediction purposes. In economics, you must know the demographics, for example, of a country. You must know how many are we as Ugandans. What is our GDP as Ugandans? What is our wealth index as Ugandans? What is the industry index? What is the price statistics? All that demographics as an economy will help you to make valid decisions. What is the employment rate? How many Ugandans are employed? All that will help you make decisions. In economics, there's also testing and validating economic theories. So if I want to know this, maybe if the theory of demand works, I'll collect data on the quantity of the products I'm looking at and its price, and go ahead and test the theory. So if you test the quantity of an economic theory, you collect the data and see if that theory is correct or not. We shall look at that under inference. And finance, of course, finance uses a lot of data, and they apply many statistical techniques to do their businesses. When they ask you for the role of statistics in business management, they want you to be specific on different business entities and explain which kind of data that entity collects in order to make the right decision. Research more on that and you will like it. In marketing, data is so much, and statistics is so much used in marketing research. The statistics gives us the audio concepts and helps us to study data by giving us a way on how to get information from data, reduce guesswork, and make valid conclusions. In marketing prices, you apply statistical techniques, compare prices of different commodities, and know how much to charge the own price. Which product should I engage in? In marketing still, in statistics, you're going to do sampling, which is so much used in marketing. If I want to market my products, like for example, I work for Moffitt. If I work for Moffitt, I may want to know, will people really appreciate my new hair products? I'll use sampling method, which is a statistical technique. Get my a few samples, go to the salons, give them. See how the women will react. The sampling is a statistical technique which can be used in marketing. Operations management, that one uses statistics techniques, uses queuing methods, programming. The queuing methods looks at the service rate and the time. For example, how long does a client take in a line before they are serviced? If I have a petrol station, how long will it take for forecast to remain in a line? Operations. Okay, we can go on top of the requests for something, so I see that the line trust will be available. Okay, we can go on. Well, on the role of the application of statistics in business management, and I say the first one is specific. Look for a business entity and tell us how you use statistics in operation. As an operations manager, operations manager looks at so much. Use statistical techniques, maybe like assignment models, which for you you don't know. Those are operations research techniques. I want to go so much detail. I'm sure now we know the meaning of statistics and the role of statistics in business management. But what are the functions? The difference between roles and functions, roles are specific, but functions are general. I'll start with the last one. With the knowledge of statistics, you're able to analyze a large mass of data. The Ministry of Finance most times tells us. Let me use the most recent. NSSF declared a problem for India. Was it 3.5% interest or 11.3%? I don't remember. On what? Interest on money to be given to the clients. Let me know in this figure. They analyzed their assets, they analyzed their investments, they analyzed a lot of things. They didn't just use guesswork. So they saw that they are getting some money from the investments they've carried out, and then they said yes. They're going to give our clients 12.35% as their interest for this year. They don't just use this word. When the Minister of Finance stands and says the interest rate is this, that's a single figure which is analyzing a large mass of data. So if you use statistical techniques to give us a single figure or a single value which summarizes a large mass of data. Let me come back to you as a student. At the end of third year, you will have your CGPA, and which will help us determine your course of degree. So, if Wilson has 2.5 and begins a class, the 2.5 figure is a single figure, but it is a summary of large mass data. You're looking at his performance. You're looking at his examinations. You're looking at his attendance. A lot of all course students he has attended from first year up to third year. So with another statistics, where we use weighted average, every faculty has an academic registrar who is in charge of that. Their experience, and they know how to use a large mass of data using statistical techniques, come up with a single figure to determine that yes, Wilson has 4.5, yes, Dr. Z has 4.9, something of that sort. So when they ask for the functions that are important, they are general. Statistics for comparison purposes. You're going to study what we coefficient operation. Coefficient operation is a very good statistical method which is used mostly for comparison purposes. How do they do it? They get the average. After getting the average, they get a standard deviation. To know which of the two groups, for example, is performing better. You're going to do variation, coefficient of variation as a course unit per se. So I won't go so much in it. Still, you can use the standard deviation itself to know which group performs better, which business performs better in terms of whichever parameters you're looking at.
So for the application, it should have been functions or importance of statistics.
Some of the functions itself can read more about them. With the knowledge of statistics, you're able to develop a model for prediction purposes. I want to screenshot again. Because I was not seeing this, so sorry. Formulation and testing hypothesis. Under statistical inference, you're going to study about hypothesis testing. But what is hypothesis testing? Hypothesis testing is a claim or an assumption on a population parameter. I should have told you before. I want you to understand, I'm going to use an example. Somebody may make a claim, or let me use a simple example. You most of you have written many projects, and you're going to do your research. Every research has an objective. Maybe you want to say, so is there a relationship between advertising costs and sales? Does it mean that people advertise more, make more sales? Who advertises so much on TV? To MTN may say yes. The more you advertise, the more sales you get. That is a claim. You as a person who wants to start a business, you have you got the field and a sample of a few businesses and see those businesses that are advertising in comparison to businesses that are not advertising. Which one is making more profits? That is hypothesis testing. You're carrying out a claim, I mean you're carrying out a test on a claim to test if that claim is true or false. We shall explain more when we do the inference which we shall reach today. Don't worry. With the knowledge of statistics, of course, you're able to measure uncertainty, you're going to do probability, which will help us or which will help you to know how you can measure uncertainty. So, read more about the meaning of statistics, the roles of statistics, and the functions of statistics. I want to look at the key concepts. The key concepts. In statistics, what is the researcher or as an analyst, you're going in the field yesterday to see if they are true or false. Somebody can make an hypothesis and say, I've made an energy drink which works. You drink this energy drink and you become strong and you get. That is just a statement, spoken or written. So it gives you as an analyst or a business analyst, what the field just gives that claim. Okay, so these are simple concepts which I want us to know: population versus sample. A statistic versus parameter. Then as I want you to read them in your books. A census versus a sample survey. So, what do you think is a population? I want us to bring it all together. What is a population to you? Write for me answers. The first 10 people. Let me also write my answer. What is a population? We are writing our answer in the chat. What is a population? Population is group of things. Population is the number of people. A tree sitting here is a large number of people. If there are few, there is a frame. A group of people in a given area by 1 square kilometer. You love the geography so much. Population data set on observations made on a given phenomenon. Okay, motto. All items of interest. Yes, Martina, that's right. Total number of people living per square meter. DB. Totality of items under study. Yes. What area? Total number of simple objects in an area at a given time. Beyond that is right, but may not be at a given time. Number of people living in the area. Population may not mean specifically people. Resource number given economy. So, a population is the totality of items under study. When somebody says population, they may not necessarily mean only people. But we have what we call a population census. When they carry out a population census, yes, the observational units or what you're getting data from is are people. You're getting data from people. That is a population census. And we have livestock census. For livestock census, now the population ceases to be people. It becomes livestock. We have agriculture censuses. Then now the population ceases to be people. And they are agriculture. So when somebody says population is the totality of items under study. We can have a population of fish in like Victoria. You want to know the total number of business of small scale businesses in Uganda. So population is the totality of items under study. And then a sample is the portion of the population under study. So most times investigations carried out on a population, which we call censuses. Investigations carried out on a population which you call censuses are rare. How long does it take in Uganda to carry out a population census? Do you remind me? I've forgotten. How long? In Uganda, how long does it take to carry out a census? 10 years, Maria. Good. 10 years. Samples and they see people are happy. pilots are bearing to test the validity and the reliability of the questionnaires. A questionnaire is just a data collection tool. So when you design a questionnaire, before going for the main census or main survey, there's what we call a pilot survey. A pilot survey is a main survey, or is an investigation carried out before the main investigation. So for you to test if your questionnaires are of quality, if they are valid or reliable, you can use a sample survey. You can sample. So that's how sampling comes in handy. So I want you to read about why do we sample? Why do we sample? Why do we have most investigation for the whole of population? Another key concept is a statistic and a parameter. If you have not been listening, if you've been playing, I want you know to be clear of these things. A statistic and a sample. Here we are studying statistics, which we say is a body of concepts and methods, which helps us to get information from the data by just know how we break the data, how we analyze it, how we organize, how we present in order to make quality decisions. That is statistics in general. But then there is what we call a statistic. Whenever people are speaking in conferences, they are always using this statistic and which danger. If I start to say the statistics of Uganda, they will speak about the population size, they will talk about the employment rates, they will talk about the GDP, they will talk about the what are the statistics in Uganda to an economist? What are the main statistics in Uganda? Employment rate, interest rate, GDP. Those are also good statistics. But sometimes they can be called parameters. They will be called parameters if they got those results from the whole population, from everyone in Uganda. But if they sampled a few people, they will call it a statistic. What are statistics of moves? Just know about moves and ask statistics in moves. They will be able to tell us the number of students they have, the number of programs they have, how much, what is the distribution of moves, the number of OBs. They can even tell us the lecturer student ratio. They will tell us how many semesters. They can tell us about the past mark. They can tell us how they matured or how they categorize the levels of classes. Which class, upper, lower class. That is the statistics in MOOCs. So I was saying that you should share between the statistics and the statistics. So this statistic, I won't write its definition in the chat. A statistic, we even have it in the notes, but I want you to write this. Is any numerical value that describes characteristics of a sample. So, any numerical value that describes the basis of a sample is called a statistic. And then we have a parameter.
So, for a parameter, is any numerical value that describes characteristics of a whole population?
That describes
characteristics of a whole population.
Of a population. census. And they are telling us about the population size. They are telling us about the population, maybe an employment rate. Those are the old parameters. They are not old statistics. So a parameter is a numerical way that describes statistics of a whole population. But then a statistic is a numerical value that describes characteristics of a sample.
So with this, network is interrupting. So I think we shall begin from there next time. Yeah, make sure you subscribe. The lecture had mentioned of me attending you guys who subscribe, so that I can feed you with this information, and it enables you to pass your final exam. So that is it for today. We shall meet in the next part to continue with the lecture.